Hello and welcome to Concepts. In this session, we will prepare a colored floor plan. I will take you through some tips and techniques about architecture presentation. When working in scale, make sure the units are set to your preference. Tap the gear icon on the top and set them under the units section. I'm going to use inches for this one. Here we are. Then let's adjust the floor plan scale by checking measure and guideline in precision menu. Use two fingers to move the guide on an area that you already know the measurements of. Once you have that, tap the gear icon to open the drawing scale section. Write down the actual dimension, which is 9.8 feet, and set the unit 2 feet. Now you have scaled floor plan where you can always measure any dimension using the guideline and major features. Make sure the layer sorting is set to automatic. This will help you keep things organized. To fill the walls, let's use marker with 100% smoothing. Change the brush thickness depending on the wall thickness you need to color. While coloring, varying the pressure will result in different color tones and will give you a nice dynamic effect to your floor plan. Now I will draw the wall outline using pen tool. Setting smoothing to 100% again will make this easier. Now it's time to import some furniture from object menu. From the import menu, tab more and go to my objects, then select the furniture group. Import the king size bed. Tap measure to show the bed dimension and scale it until the length is 6.3 feet. Now, when you import the single bed, there is no need to use the major feature. Just make sure it has the same length of the king bed. Then just import the remaining furniture using the same technique. Use the fill tool to fill the flooring. You don't have to worry about irregular lines at this point. You can always fix them later using the mask tool. Also, we can use the dotted band to hide any intersection between filled area. The nudge is a great tool for refining things or correcting any imperfections. Finally, we'll give some depth to the floor plan by dropping shadows using the fill tool. Pay attention where you start the fill stroke, as the last closing edge is perfectly straight. Then I intended to have the longest and hardest exposed edge by the end. Now it's time to add text and titles to your floor plan. By having your layer sorted automatically, you can select the content of any layer and control its tool, thickness, or color at any point. There are several ways to select the content of a layer. One way is to isolate the layer you want to adjust. Just double tap on it. Select the stroke you want to adjust. and change the thickness of the active brush. Having presentable floor plan helps the client to understand it and helps you to sell your idea.